Meet the Press with Paul Bongiorno.
Good morning and welcome to Meet the Press. As the government prepares to deliver what it calls the most difficult budget in living memory, the argument over the future of the planet has taken on the intensity of global warming itself. On Monday, flanked by his ministers, the Prime Minister appeared to capitulate to the opposition over the timing and start-up of its emissions trading scheme.
It's time to get off the fence, Mr. Turnbull, and it's time to act in the national interest and to secure this legislation and certainty for the future.
The Greens were purple with rage, and the Liberals in no hurry to accommodate.
We cannot have a situation where we support a scheme which will lead to tens of thousands of Australians out of work and with no substantial cuts in CO2 emissions into the bargain.
Shadow Minister for Infrastructure and Emissions Trading, Andrew Robb, is a guest. And later, Chris Richardson from Access Economics peers into his budget crystal ball. But first, what's making news in the nation's papers this Sunday, May 10? The Sunday Mail has the headline, Federal Treasurer Wayne Swan promises budget pain. Mr. Swan admitted yesterday key Labor election promises would be broken in the budget. The Sunday Age strikes a Mother's Day theme with maternity leave scheme in as soon as July 1. A universal 18-week paid maternity leave scheme will be sold as a stimulus measure and will cost $450 million a year. While the Sun Herald carries the front page lead, Don't Forget Single Mums, the paper says more than 350,000 single parents will be left out of pension rises in the budget. The Herald Sun has Mexico's swine flu toll on rise again. The number of Mexicans confirmed killed by the new virus has risen by 3 to 48.